We are continuing forward now with accounting and the time value of money. And up until now, we've been looking at how to solve for the present value or the future value amounts. But there are times when we actually may know the present value and the future value, and maybe we want to find the interest rate that we would need or the number of periods we need to save. So we can also use this time value of money information to be able to solve for those amounts. So let's just look at some examples on how we can do that. Well, let's first look at solving for the number of periods. So you're in the equation there. So the village of Seminoc wants to accumulate $70,000 for the construction of a veterans monument in the town square. At the beginning of the current year, the village deposited $47,811 in a memorial fund that earns 10% interest compounded annually. How many years will it take to accumulate $70,000 in the memorial fund? So as you can see, we know lots of information, but we don't know how many years it's going to take. So we're looking for our N, as you can see in the timeline here. So there's a couple of methods we can actually use to find this amount. The first method is called the future value approach. So with this approach in the box there, you see the information in red, we're going to set the future value equal to the present value times the future value factor at a certain number of periods and 10% interest. And again, we're looking for that little n. We're looking for the number of periods. So the unknown amount is that future value factor. So we have $70,000 is equal to $47,811 times our unknown, or our x. In this case, the future value factor. So we're going to divide both sides by the $47,811 to get the future value factor on one side by itself, just like we're solving an algebraic expression for our x, our unknown. And we find the future value factor to be 1.46410. So if we look for that number in our chart, we know it's at 10% interest. So if we go down the 10% column, we find that 1.46410 at the 4-period mark. So we know that the number of periods it will take to accumulate $70,000 by first depositing $47,811 at 10%, it will take us 4 years to accumulate $70,000. We can also use what's called the present value approach. This is setting the present value equal to the future value times the present value factor at a certain number of periods and 10%. So again, that's our unknown, that present value factor amount. So we want to get that on one side of the equation by itself. So dividing both sides by the $70,000 gets us a present value factor of 0.68301. So we know it's 10% interest, so we go to our 10% column in our table, and we scan down until we find that factor. 0.68301 happens to be, again, at the 4 periods. So no matter which method or approach you use, the present value approach or the future value approach, you should still get the same answer. In this case, it's 4 periods. We can also use these two different approaches to solve for interest rates. So here we have Advanced Design Incorporated. They need $1,409,870 for basic research 5 years from now. The company currently has $800,000 to invest for that purpose. At what rate of interest must it invest the $800,000 to fund basic research projects of $1,409,870 5 years from now? So again, as you can see on our timeline, the piece that we're missing here is the interest rate. So what interest rate are we going to need to be able to invest $800,000 today for over the next 5 years and end up with a little over $1.4 million? Well, again, we can use the future value and the present value approaches. So let's look at the future value approach firstly. So again, we start with setting the future value equal to the present value times the future value factor at 5 periods, and we don't know the interest rate. So again, that piece is our unknown. So we have our $1,409,870 set equal to $800,000 times the future value factor, which is what we're solving for. Get that by itself on one side of the equation, and you find that the future value factor is 1.76234. And we know the number of periods is 5. So if we start with the number of periods are 5, and then we scan over until we find 1.76234, we find that the interest rate we will need to get to end up with a little over $1.4 million, investing $8 million today for 5 years, we would need to get 12% on our money. Now, this was using the future value approach. So remember, we can also use the present value approach to solve for that 12%, and it should come out to be the same answer. It should not change our answer. So let's take a look at it. So here we start with the present value now equal to the future value times the present value factor. And if we do that, we find that $800,000 equals 1,409,870x, our unknown, that present value factor. If we solve for that present value factor, we come up with 0.56743. And again, we know that's at 5 periods. So now we scan over across our paper there, across our time value of money tables, and we find that number again in the 12% column. So we are able to see that 12% is our rate to invest $800,000 today. Over the next 5 years, we will need to be achieving a 12% rate to be able to come up with a little over $1.4 million 5 years from now.